మేము అప్లోడ్ చేసే ఈ వీడియోస్ మీ మొబైల్కి నోటిఫికేషన్స్లా రావాలంటే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, అలానే బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయండి. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు రిసీవ్ మై వీడియోస్ టు యువర్ మొబైల్ యాజ్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ క్లిక్ ఆన్ బెల్ ఐకాన్. ప్లీజ్ వాచ్ అండ్ షేర్ టు యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు మోటివేట్ అస్. మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్కి షేర్ చేయండి మా వీడియోస్.
Hi, this part of the tutorial details about the practical steps to use the sequence and if activity to check whether the given year is a leap year or not. Now, in the earlier session, we already used the flow chart and the flow activity to validate this condition. Now, we are going to use this. Now, from the file start, you can create a new process. If you want to create a new process, and give a name to organize the processes and select the valid location to save the processes. And click on create. Whenever it creates the new process, it will open and organize the new process in the UIPath studio. From the left hand side, you can observe the activities, and in the middle portion, you can see the workflow designer where you should organize the activities and logic over there. So here you can use the flowchart as a starting point for the entire process. This is a best practice if you want to organize your work in the complex process. So I am dragging the flowchart activity from the left side to the workflow designer. When you drag, you can see the start button. As part of this tutorial, I thought to show the sequence, right? So here I am going to use the sequence within the flow chart where our entire critical logic goes into the sequence basically. Here I am going to rename the main flow chart which we dragged earlier to the name main flow chart. Just I double clicked that particular name which allowed me to edit to main flow chart, which indicates that this is the starting point for the entire process. Now search for the sequence activity from the left hand side and drag and drop inside the main flowchart. This sequence is going to have our core logic to validate the given year is leap year or not. So view the sequence. Now connect the sequence from the start node. Just hover the start menu and drag the arrow to the sequence. Now you can double click the sequence activity to rename it or give the meaningful name to it. So I am giving the sequence name as leapyear sequence. So always try to follow some naming conventions. You know, in the enterprise environment, if your team is working on these UIPath things, you always maintain a document about the naming conventions. You know, what kind of names we should give to the flowchart, what kind of naming convention we should give to the activities, means capital or small, or you know, all these things. You always maintain a document. Not only capital or small, you know, if your entire process has subparts, how to organize such that each one can distinguish the process easily. Now give the input dialog where user can enter the value of the year to validate whether that is leap year or not. So now go to the activities panel and search for the input dialog and then drag it into the sequence. Not exactly into the sequence, in the flowchart itself, in between start and the sequence, in between you can drag and drop it. Or if you want to, you can do in the both the ways. Okay, you can drag in between them, or if you want to do in the sequence itself, you can do it. I dragged into the sequence. So select that particular input dialog and give the label name, like please enter here or something like that, and go to the output result variable value. There simply you can type like set name colon and give the variable name, which allows you to create a variable, or just right click on the particular value field, which shows a kind of pop-up where you can create the variable using the create variable, or you can go to the variables panel just below the workflow designer. There itself you can create a variable. So you have the multiple options possible. You can use the set name colon, or you can just right click the result field, or you can use the variables panel. Yes, I am right clicking here. Here you can see the create variable, right? Yeah, when you click on that, you can see set name colon. There you can give the year and then enter. You can see that value in the variable section also. There variable type is important. Here we are going to validate the year, so you can give the type as integer. I already mentioned in the output property, right click and select create variable to create variable, which automatically reflects in the variable section as well. Just go there and change the data type. Earlier in the flowchart related process, we use the flow decision activity. Now we should use the if activity here to validate the condition. Just search for if one, drag and drop into the sequence below the input dialog. When you drag and drop, you can see if condition then else. Just select the condition field from the properties pane, you can see, or within the condition field itself you can type. Here the logic should be ear mod 4 equal to 0. So when we divide the ear value by 4, the remainder should be 0, then it is a kind of leap ear. If the remainder is not 0 when we divide the ear by 4, it is not a leap ear. That is the logic. So we are maintaining that in the condition. Now go to the then is like if the condition is met, you simply you can drag a message box to display that this is second leap year. Just drag the message box activity from the left side into the then block and double click the message box to enter that particular text in the double quotes like this is leap year. There you can enter the string in the double quotes like this is leap year. If you don't enter perfectly, you may see blue compiler error related warning. Similarly, for the else condition also, you drag and drop another message box. We should display a kind of message. This is not a leap year. Save the process and test it. Click on run to test it. When you run, it displays the input field. Just give the variable ear value. Something like that, 2019. This is not a leap year. Give 2020, then you can get that this is the leap year. I hope you tested perfectly. If you like this video, like it and share to your friends. Follow the social links below the video. As part of this tutorial, we used the sequence and the if condition. In the earlier tutorial, we used the flow decision and flow chart to test an ear as a leap year or not. Thank you very much for watching this video.
మేము అప్లోడ్ చేసే ఈ వీడియోస్ మీ మొబైల్కి నోటిఫికేషన్స్లా రావాలంటే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, అలానే బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయండి. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు రిసీవ్ మై వీడియోస్ టు యువర్ మొబైల్ యాజ్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ క్లిక్ ఆన్ బెల్ ఐకాన్. ప్లీజ్ వాచ్ అండ్ షేర్ టు యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు మోటివేట్ అస్. మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్కి షేర్ చేయండి మా వీడియోస్.